The thought is that you can go another little further step forward. These are experimental curves from a junction that we design in a certain way. The one I showed you before, it was on niobium nitride MgO niobium nitride barrier. We have seen that on this junction. We have seen on also on some ferromagnetic junctions, we have seen different systems. And this is, I would say, very educative, because you see that in the difference of nature, there are some things which are absolutely similar. And so you are more self-confident about the effects. So, and then we also observed, because we wanted to go to ITC and see if how much to trust in an ITC that is not only one junction, where you're always afraid that some artifacts may happen. So the idea is that we were using some kind of substrate strontium titanate, which gives stray capacitance relevant. So we changed that by using lanthanum aluminate substrates, reducing this effect, and that's what we measure. And I will explain in a moment why things make sense. So in this case, the switching profiles, you know, there is not even more the thermal part. They start like that. When we decrease when we increase the temperature, they become narrower and higher. It's completely the opposite way we have discussed before. If we plot the sigma, we have this saturation at low temperature, this quantum. And then we have this, there is no thermal part, we have right away the fall down of the what we call the diffusion part. And if you try to fit this part, here there are Monte Carlo simulations with different Q factors, you see that you can fit this very carefully with the one of these curve with Monte Carlo simulations that are not the phase diffusive part. What is nice in this cartoon is that actually the experiment worked in the sense that we were able to by changing, so the point is that we have the crossover temperature, and the crossover temperature, this is between quantum and thermal, and this is between phase diffusion and thermal. So one depends on the critical current, this one depends on the square critical current on the capacitance. By changing the substrate, we were able to use the crossover temperature, and that's what we did. We switched somehow the crossover temperature and between thermal and quantum, and between phase diffusion and thermal, and we were able to somehow cancel the thermal part. And this is somehow further confirmation of the whole picture. And on top of that, what was also quite important is that, again, I want to say that here we have some kind of junctions that we cannot master so well, like aluminum. But this junction that, nature gives, it's why BCO the way grows. The same way I would say could happen with nanowires, with topological insulators. The point is, do we need to throw them, or we need to understand if there is some kind of margin of control in the quantum phase? This tells that if dissipation is relatively in some limits, in this case is above one, the Q factor is above one, we are also able to measure through the fall off of this curve exactly the dissipation of junction, so how much this couples to the environment. And also in this case, we measured as a function of magnetic field, and we were able to tune the crossover temperature between, in this case, the quantum regime and the phase diffusion regime. As I told you before, it was quite important to have this kind of Monte Carlo simulations to understand how fast this transition would occur. At this point, we also made some kind of phase diagram. There was also one before I presented by Pecola group. And what is nice is that here, for these junctions where dissipation, so here we are, before I discuss the junction with very high Q factor that have macroscopic quantum tunneling and then wonderful thermal behavior. In this case, we are somehow enlarging our capability of understanding junctions in more dissipative conditions. And here, for instance, again, I would like to point that If we plot as a function of temperature quality factor, we have this quantum regime, we have thermal activation, phase diffusion. Depending on the quality factor here, we can have this kind of regime where we pass from phase diffusion to quantum activation. And this is somehow neatly, I would say, demonstrated by this kind of curves that gives very, you know, at the first look, they give indications. Obviously, we do fine-tuning of all these curves, and we understand that this is very accurate. We change the magnetic field, and so we are able to build this phase diffusion and diagram. Yes?
This would show that to make the transition from quantum to phase diffusion is in a very narrow region. So you have to be...
Yes, yes.
It's a very special junction.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because the most general condition is to go from quantum thermal
absolutely.
Diffusion or...
Absolutely, absolutely. We just fill this part of the phase diagram. Here the points are our junctions from Pecola, all the junctions which are in literature. Lucens, they are here. But Leandro, the point is that, you know, again, going to direction, then I will come this to the end of my talk. You know, in some junctions, you know, if you have aluminum technology, you can do everything very accurate. But we all know that also people that want to do qubits, IBM, they are concerned about reproducibility of aluminum junctions, because if you want to have 50 junctions, fine. If you want to have 1,000, it's a problem for our... So the point is that, for instance, if you have ferromagnetic junction, you may be not comparable with quality factor, but you may have some advantages in driving the junction. So if nature gives you these quality factors, can you do some use? That's the And so from our point of view, we have completely filled this phase diagram region. And obviously, you can go even lower, you know, you can further decrease JC, and this is again in our again done on ITC junctions, here you see something that in general is not easily understandable with the RSJ model. So you have some kind of hysteretic behavior, but you have bending. This has been explained by Kautz, I mentioned also before, by assuming that in this case there is a quality factor which changes with frequencies. So if you take into account this change of frequency in Monte Carlo simulations, you can understand that there is this hysteretic behavior mixed with bending. That's something that with RSJ you cannot understand. So again, in a nano world, you need to have these kind of tools, and I will show you that it's not obviously high TC. Then we use their you know, these two quality factors, and we're able to fit also the switching distributions and the temperature behavior. When we further reduced EC and JC, before we were about 50, now we are at 10 nanoamps. You know, there is no way where you can fit also with this noise, you know, with this Monte Carlo simulations, the IV curves. And actually, we are at values of Coulomb energy and Joule energy extremely low. These JC are very low. Again, you know, it's not confined to ITC, and to prove that, I go back to literature. I go back to literature and to the work of Tinkham Group, to these very old but important papers, where again they observe this kind of hysteretic behavior with this clear phase diffusion branch. What happens here is that you at some point these slopes becomes independent of temperature, and basically the story will stop here. Not that the seminar, but the story is that at this point you are really at the very limit where you start need working on the charge. It's not, you know, energy just energy is so low that charging energy is so important. How we have said that at the beginning, but what is And here I don't think that there is any answer in literature for any kind of junction. So we just went to the point to reproduce what has been seen on low TC junctions, and to see that, you know, also in this case you have iterative behavior and bending, but without any conclusion. And also in our case we saw this kind of slope for this temperature, but without saturation. You know, this brings to some kind of nice future problem that that has been largely discussed in literature from the theoretical point of view about quantum Brownian motion with large friction. And this is nice work by Christian Nast. And basically, you know, this is there's a lot of that analysis, but basically I want to give the idea that that in this case the phase is so delocalized that the problem of tunneling is different, because you don't belong anymore to just one valley, but you belong to different valleys, and frictions makes that these barriers are much lower. And so the problem of these quantum Brownian motion, so quantum effects for very dissipative systems, is more complicated, and for sure you are talking about something delocalized in phase. So and there are quite some good predictions, you know, some good ideas from theory. And from my point of view, I would say that we have, looking to literature and what we have been doing, we have some kind of reasonable good understanding of all these parts. And here I would stress you that, you know, this phase diagram, quantum activation, thermal activation, obviously this is the most delicate part, because when the junction have high quality factor, there is no problem. But we have understanding of what's happening, and I would like to stress here that here is, the critical parameter is JC. So when we change JC in this range, we see this kind of, this is somehow very important, because it's a way of measure dissipation. And these are, we are going to see shortly. It was not supposed to be here. It's okay. So just a joke about dissipation. You know, that's the way I depict in my mind. It's not complete, but you know, we are able to measure the. This is somehow the junction, and this is the environment, when the environment destroys the behavior of the junction. And we are able to understand all these processes for all these kind of junctions. And then they could put in other whatever kind of circuit. But this was the preliminary information. Okay, so I want to treat the other extreme limit, and we are getting to the end. And this is the IV curve overdamped. These are the underdamped, the classic underdamped. Before I told you to be careful about this difference. If you put inside the microwaves, inside, you may not even understand that this is, because you probably care about the general quality factor. But this may have different dissipations, and we know since the 80s. So what we did, we also were able so these are the two junctions I showed you before. This is a functional GC. One is one sample, the other sample I showed you before. And then we were also able, by changing the material orientation angle in the bipartite junctions, to get these kind of profiles of the switching current probabilities. This is to give you, again, an idea of how accurate is this system of understanding the physics of dissipation and macroscopic quantum tunneling through the analysis of the switching current distributions. So this is, these are the curves. The width, and here okay these are the distributions again for different temperatures. Now I draw your attention here. So this is the niobium sample I've shown you before. This is another junction I've shown you before, where we have shown the transition thermal and phase diffusion. This is the width for this special sample. So at the first look, if we would not go into all qualitative analysis, we would see that this, you know, this seems to be like phase diffusion, decrease and then increase. But if you do carefully quantitative analysis, you see that here the width is quite unreasonable. The point is exactly that you cannot fit with anything physical, with any physical parameters, this kind of distributions, because actually the physics is different. When JC is so high, you basically something else is happening. And actually we were able to model that by using the model of Packer-Goldbach. This comes from nanowires, but it's somehow different physics, in the sense that something, you know, it's different physics but still occurring in junction. So we took inspiration from here, and basically what is driving this switching is not anymore the phase, but is basically a heating mechanism. So we are not talking anymore about electrodynamical parameters, but we are talking about specific heat and how fast the nanowire, the junction can bring heat. And what we claim is that actually you can clearly, by investigating this switching probability, you can clearly understand that for when JC is very high, it's not anymore driven by the phase, but it's driven by heating mechanism. And this is, again, I stress, high JC. And so you do the fitting, and you use this model, and you extract reasonable numbers, and you get quite a fairly good understanding that this is only due to heating. And actually, you also understand that when we call them phase leap, they are just heating events. And when you are at low temperatures, you know, you